الحمد لله الحمد لله رب الأرض والسماوات بيده الخيرات يسبح له من في السماوات والأرض والطير صافات أحمد ربي سبحانه وأشكره على نعمه التي لا يحصيها أحد من المخلوقات وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له أحسن الأسماء والصفات وأشهد أن نبينا وسيدنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله المؤيد بالمعجزات صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وذريته والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين الذين فازوا بعز الدنيا وفي الآخرة بالروضات الجنات أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وآمنوا برسوله يؤتكم كفلين من رحمته ويجعل لكم نورا تمشون به ويغفر لكم والله غفور رحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد Dear respected brothers and sisters, usually when we travel to a distant place, when we travel abroad, or to a place we've never been before, as a human being, we have the habit of bringing back souvenirs, gifts from those places that we've been to our friends and our relatives. Those gifts indicate that we traveled afar, and that also that we cared about them on the way back. So when we go to Hajj, we like to bring back Zamzam. Zamzam water, tamra, you know, different types of dates, ajwa, sukari, whatever you like, sajada, and dhikr beads. Alhamdulillah. This is part of the human behavior. We do that all the time. If you live overseas, you come to America, you want to take back everything you can from America. Subhanallah. But I want to share with you how two of the greatest of the Anbiya, when they went on a journey, they brought the best things back to the people, whether the people accepted it or not. And that is, what is the best gift you can bring back? I want us to reflect upon. Let's take, for example, Musa alayhi salam. Musa traveled one time. Subhanallah, Allah tells us in Surah Al-Qasas, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فلما قضى موسى الأجل وسار بأهله آنس من جانب الطور نارا. That when Musa completed his term in Madian, he traveled back to Egypt with his family. And when you travel back then at night, you don't have a car, and they may have traveled with maybe a camel or two, or on foot. They don't have lights. It's cold and dark. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to get his attention by showing him fire on the side of a mount. When Musa came close, that was his first meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Musa, in Surah Taha, إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدْنِي وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي SubhanAllah, Allah meets Musa the first time and he's already giving him a prescription. Tawheed and then As-Salah. So when Musa comes back to Egypt, to the people, his da'wah is twofold. To Bani Israel is to bring them back to the path of ibadah, and to the people of Fir'aun is to bring them on the path of Tawheed and ibadah. SubhanAllah. So that's the gift Musa had to bring back. In the desert, there's nothing to find. So he never brought fruits from Madian or anything. He brought As-Salah to Bani Israel. And even while they're in Egypt, Allah made As-Salah binding upon them, as he states in Surah Yunus, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَى مُوسَى وَأَخِيهِ أَن تَبَوَّأَ لِقَوْمِكُمَا بِمِصْرَ بُيُوتًا وَاجْعَلُوا بُيُوتَكُمْ قِبْلَةً وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. That Allah ordered Musa and Harun to make the Bani Israel use their homes to establish a salah. Make it as a qibla, subhanallah. So that's Musa's journey. My question to you and I, what happened when the Prophet ﷺ also journeyed by night? As Allah states in Al-Israa, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهِ لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. Think about this, brothers and sisters. Many of us misread the beginning of Al-Isra by ignoring what it actually says. We think of the night journey of the Prophet ﷺ like a journey he himself went on by his own volition. That he decided one night, I'm going to leave Mecca and go to Al-Quds. Rather, Allah says, he himself, Allah, سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ. It is Allah who took his servant, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on this night journey. For one reason, لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. If you went from Mecca to Al-Quds, 1400 years ago, there's nothing to sightsee at night. It is dark, there's no electricity, so you won't see where you're going. You won't get to see the trees in Al-Quds or any of that. If you went to Masjid Al-Aqsa, you won't be able to see much in there. That is why Allah took him far beyond the creation to show him those signs. On that journey, we have this beautiful hadith, as you all may have already heard parts of it, by Anas ibn Malik, the hadith from Imam Ahmad. That is a very detailed, long hadith about how Jibril came, bring out al-Buraq, and so. I'm just going to mention the part where the Prophet ﷺ met with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you doubt, I know that. If you doubt that the Prophet ﷺ actually went on this journey to meet Allah, don't take my word for it. Put the hadith aside. Take what Allah revealed about it in Surah An-Najm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the Prophet ﷺ traveled so far, he reached the outer limit of creation. In Surah An-Najm, Allah says, أَفَتُمَارُونَهُ عَلَى مَا يَرَى. Do you doubt the messenger about what he said he saw? وَلَقَدْ رَآهُ نَزْلَةً أُخْرَى عِنْدَ سِدْرَةِ الْمُنْتَهَى عِنْدَهَا جَنَّةُ الْمَأْوَى. Allah says the Prophet ﷺ went to where Jannah is. Allah said that. Put the hadith aside. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَقَدْ رَآ مِنْ آيَاتِ رَبِّهِ الْكُبْرَى. He saw the greatest signs of Allah no one has ever seen. On the way back, here comes the hadith. The Prophet ﷺ says, when he met with Allah, فَأَوْحَى اللَّهُ إِلَيَّ مَا أَوْحَى. Allah inspired me with whatever he wanted. وَقَدْ فَرَضَ عَلَيَّ خَمْسِينَ صَلَاتًا فِي كُلِّ يَوْمِ وَلَيْلَةً. And then he prescribed 50 salawat for me every day and every night, meaning 24 hours. فَنَزَلْتُ حَتَّى إِنْتَهَيْتُ إِلَى مُوسَى. I descended until I met up with Musa. So Musa asked the Prophet ﷺ a question. Musa traveled and he received wahi on his journey and a salah. Musa then asked the Prophet ﷺ, مَا فَرَضَ رَبُّكَ عَلَى أُمَّتِكَ. What did Allah prescribe for your ummah? Prophet ﷺ said, خَمْسِينَ صَلَاتَ فِي كُلِّ يَوْمِ وَلَيْلَةً. 50 salawat a day. He said, ارجع إلى ربك فاسأله تخفيف لأمتك فإن أمتك لا تطيق ذلك وإني قد بلوت بني إسرائيل فخبرتهم. He said, go back and ask Allah to lighten it upon your ummah, because your ummah cannot do it. I know this because I went through this with Bani Israel and I found out they just can't. So the Prophet says, فرجعت. He went back to Allah and he asked Allah this way. Ay Rabbi khaffif an ummati. Oh my Lord, in such a humble, respectful way, he said, lighten it for my ummah. So Allah reduced it by 5. He said, فَحَطَّ عَنِّي خَمْسَ. When he came back down, he meets Musa. Musa said, مَا فَعَلْتُ. What did you do? He said, قَدْ حَطَّ عَنِّي خَمْسَ. It's reduced by 5. He said, ارجع إلى ربك فاسأله تخفيف لأمتك. Ask Allah to reduce it again. He can't. And the Prophet ﷺ went back. He says, فَلَمْ أَزَلْ أَرْجِعُ بَيْنَ رَبِّي وَبَيْنَ مُوسَى وَيَحُطُ عَنِّي خَمْسًا خَمْسًا حَتَّى قَالْ. I kept going back between my Lord and Musa, and it was reduced 5 by 5 until Allah said this. يَا مُحَمَّدْ هُنَّ خَمْسُ صَلَوَاتِ. For the only time we have in Wahy, Allah refers to the Prophet ﷺ as يَا مُحَمَّدْ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. In the entire Quran, when Allah refers directly to His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya ayyuhan nabi and Ya ayyuhan rasul, and never by His name. The only time is when He and Allah are only having a conversation without Jibreel, without you and I, without anyone. Allahu Akbar. Even Allah has respect for the Messenger. That's why Allah forbade us to ever call Him by His name. Subhanallah. La taj'alu du'a ar-rasuli baynakum ka du'a ba'dikum ba'd. Don't call him like call yourself. La tarfa'u aswatakum fawqa sawti an-nabi. Wa la tajharu lahu bil qawl ka jahri ba'dikum li ba'd. Allahu Akbar. Then we got 5 salawat, and Allah says, "Bi kulli salatin 'ashr." For each salah you get 10 times the reward. He came back down. Musa says, "Irji' ila rabbik." Reduce it less than 5. The Prophet ﷺ said this, لَقَدْ رَجَعْتُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي حَتَّى إِسْتَحْيَيْتُ. I kept going back to Allah until I got shy. No more. No less than 5. That's the gift we got from Al-Israa and Al-Mi'raaj. The Anbiya, the greatest of them, received this type of prescription in their journeys. So As-Salah is extremely important, brothers and sisters, to all creation. And that is why we should hold As-Salah during this pandemic even more so dear, because one by one this disease might claim our lives. We may lose the use of this place if it gets too worse. So every opportunity you have to come, come fi sabilillah, because this is the most important thing we got from Al-Isra and Al-Mi'raj. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an wa sunnah. ونفعني وإياكم بما فيهما من الآيات والحكمة. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. Brothers and sisters, you know, sometimes we try to turn on our scientific and logical brains to understand Al-Isra and Al-Mi'raj. And then we think about it scientifically, we say, it's not possible to have happened because you cannot travel that far in a day or in an hour or two. That is true. The universe is 13.7 billion years old, but it is nearly 100 billion light years wide now because of its expansion. So if the Prophet ﷺ traveled by the limitations of this dunya, the speed of light, he would not have returned yet. He would not have even crossed our galaxy. He would not have gone far. And yet Allah said the malaika come down and return with his orders in a day. تَعْرُجُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَالْرُوحُ إِلَيْهِ فِي يَوْمٍ كَانَ مِقْدَارُهُ خَمْسِينَ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ. Who was the guide in this journey? Jibreel alayhi salam. And who took the Prophet on this journey? Allah Himself. سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِي. Allah is telling us, I took him on this journey. We fail to read the very first word of the ayah. We only think about Star Trek and Star Wars because of Hollywood. That's why we cannot understand what Allah is saying. Put that aside. As-Salah, why is Salah so important that Allah has to call him above the heavens to tell him this? Allah could have just revealed it in Quran. Read 5 times a day, that's it. Allah said, I wanted to show him what I created. Brothers and sisters, why is Salah so important? Allah states in Surah An-Nur, Surah number 24, Ayah number 41. He said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالطَّيْرُ صَافَّاتِ. Allah says, do you not see that everything makes tasbih to Allah? Those in the heavens and on earth, what tayyibu self, even the birds that fly. Haven't you seen geese and ducks fly? For south for winter or come back? They always fly like an arrow. Or when birds fly, it's an amir and everyone else follows from side. And they always communicate with each other, going back and forth. Allah says, what tayyibu self fat, even when they fly, they make tasbih. And then Allah says, كُلٌّ قَدْ عَلِمَ صَلَاتَهُ وَتَسْبِيحًا. That every living creature makes salah and tasbih. It's not enough to just wake up in the morning and say, Subhanallah. Allah wants you to make salah. Allah says the birds make salah. Allahu Akbar. That's why salah is important. Every created thing makes tasbih, makes sajda, which is the pinnacle of your salah. Your lowest point in salah is your face on the ground to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That sajda, everything makes it. Allah states in Surah Al-Nahl. He said, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ يَتَفَيَّأُ ظِلَالُهُ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ وَالشَّمَائِلِ سُجَّدًا لِلَّهِ وَهُمْ دَاخِرُونَ. Allah says, even a stick, a tree on the ground that you see stationary, an object, they all make a form of sajda to Allah. The sun, the moon, the stars, the plants, the animals. That's why salah is important. It's the only relationship we have with our Creator, because وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. This ibadah and salah is the most regular ibadah. If you think that salah was only prescribed for this ummah, not so. Let's start with Ibrahim alayhi salam. He said, when he left his family, Surah to Ibrahim, Surah number 14, ayah number 37. رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. That he left his family in Mecca to establish a salah. His ending dua, رَبِّ جَعَلْنِي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّةِ رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَى. That Ibrahim alayhi salam. Musa, you already know, Allah tell him, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. What about Isa? Forget about Musa, Isa. Let's go to Ismail alayhi salam. Surah Maryam, Surah number 19. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ayah 54-55, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِسْمَعِيلِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَادِقَ الْوَعْدِ وَكَانَ رَسُولَ النَّبِيَّ وَكَانَ يَأْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ وَكَانَ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ مَرْضِيًّا. That's Ismail who followed Ibrahim. What about Isa? When he was born as a baby, when they presented him, فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ. What did he say to the people? قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ آتَانِيَ الْكِتَابِ وَجَعْلَنِي نَبِيَّ وَجَعْلَنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتِ وَأَوْصَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيَّ. Surah Maryam, ayah number 30 and above. All the anbiya are required to make salah. All the living creatures are required to make salah. Salah is so important. Allah says, if you are somewhere, bullets are flying and bombs are going off, Allah says, فَلَيْسَ جَنَاحَ عَلَيْكُمْ أَن تَقْصُرُوا مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ إِنْ خِفْتُمْ أَن يَفْتِنَكُمُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Even in Al-Ghazwa, you have to make at least two rak'ah. And Allah revealed it in Surah An-Nisa. He told the Prophet, وَإِذَا كُنْتَ فِيهِمْ فَأَقَمْتَ لَهُمُ الصَّلَاةِ فَلْتَكُمْ طَائِفَةٌ مِّنْهُمْ مَعَكْ وَلْيَأْخُذُوا أَسْلِحَتَهُمْ. Pray with your weapon in your hand if you have to. In Islam, you can pray standing, sitting like that. قُعُودًا. Allah says you can stand or sit. قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِكُمْ. In that, Allah says, حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ الْوُسْطَى وَقُومُوا لِلَّهِ قَانِتِينَ فَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ فَرِجَالًا أَوْ رُكْبَانًا. Surah Al-Baqarah. Salah is so important. It's the only act of worship. There is no exemption except suspension for the person who is not mentally there or is not awake. Zakah, you have to meet the nisab. Fasting, you have to be healthy. Hajj, man istata' ilayhi sabila. Salah, everyone is required to pray except one who does not reach purity or is insane. And if you're sleeping, you wake up, you make it up. Allahu Akbar. We ask Allah to bless this gathering for coming out during this COVID and to never forget this barakah during this time of as-salah. And then Ramadan is right around the corner where we truly get to enjoy the Quran and as-salah. So may Allah give that to us. Allahumma ameen. Brothers and sisters, in the month of Rajab, some Muslims like to celebrate Al-Israa and Al-Mi'raaj. Wallahi, we do not know which month that took place. There's no Sahih Hadith, no Hasan Hadith, no Da'if Hadith. Nothing. I don't know who started it and why. Don't join those celebrations. If you truly believe in Al-Israa and Al-Mi'raaj, hafidhu ala salawat wa salati al-wusta. Inna Allah malaikatahu yusalluna ala al-Nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala al Muhammad. Kama sallaita wa sallamta wa barakta ala Ibrahim. Wa ala al Ibrahim innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma hadina fi man hadait. وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وانصر الإسلام والمسلمين واغفر لجميع موتى المسلمين يا عزيز يا كريم اللهم أهل علينا شهر رمضان بالأمن والإيمان السلامة والإسلام ونحن في صحة وعافية والسلم والسلامة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أعد علينا شهر رمضان أعواما عديدة وأزلنة مديدة ونحن في صحة وعافية يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا اغفر لنا وارحمنا وأنت خير الراحمين اللهم اجعلنا من التائبون العابدون الحامدون السائحون الراكعون الساجدون الآمرون بالمعروف والناهون عن المنكر والحافظون لحدود الله برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وأقيموا الصلاة فإن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر وذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.